under 191.53. So restructuring is really deals with administrative efficiency. So you may file your claim in a cumbersome way, at least from the customs point of view, and customs becomes annoyed. So they say, okay, you need to restructure the way you make your claims. So for example, on form CBP, CBP form 7551, the drawback entry, right? You may be filing only one line item per drawback entry, and you may do that because for whatever reasons you have, it's easier for you to keep the data keeping, it's easier for you to do this accounting thing. All right, no problem. But for you, no problem. But customs says, hey, listen, why don't you just consolidate all your stuff instead of me writing it out, giving you the separate drawback entry number for all your import entries, for per one import entry. I just want to give one drawback number for many entries. And to me, it's more efficient, so I don't have to keep track, enter this into the database if it's a manual entry. I do not have to, I can save myself time if you will help me on this one. Just write down several entries, not just one entry per drawback. I'm talking about the import entry. So we're talking about the concept of administrative efficiency. So customs says restructure your claim in favorable way so that I can more administratively efficiently do my job. So this is claim restructuring. So because we live in a world of rules and regulations, of course customs cannot decide this for whatever reasons. There is a set of reasons why customs may want to do that, and there is a set of reasons the drawback claimant can respond in by saying no. And this is the point of claim restructuring, is what is the guiding criteria. So as I mentioned before, the guiding criteria is mentioned in 191 section 53, restructuring of claims. And the factors for the CBP decision include the number of transactions, value of claims, frequency of claims, type of product being claims, and drawback ruling. But customs may not require a claimant to restructure if one of those following things apply. And this would be the reason for you to come to customs and say, no, customs, I qualify for an exemption from claim restructuring because I either have multiple commodities, meaning so I import food and computers at the same time, and both of them are subject to drawback, but I'd rather to deal with food products under the separate drawback claim as opposed to the computer products, because they are subject to different manufacturing processes, they are subject to different accounting processes, and they are subject to different warehousing processes, for example. So because even though those two commodities are brought under one umbrella, I still want to use two different drawback claims to differentiate. So that would be one example. Drawback ruling. So you file a ruling with customs, and customs says this is how this is the treatment you must afford to this particular type of commodity. Multiple manufacturing locations. So we're talking about the geography factor. Difficulty in adjusting accounting and inventory methods. So it kind of goes back to the example with multiple commodities, where you have different set of systems and you want to keep one set of system homogeneous to one set of product, while another system to a different set of products. Significantly different method of operation, variable conflicting manufacturing and inventory periods. So the bottom here is restructuring. The bottom line is the restructuring should not be allowed if it makes it's very burdensome for the drawback claimant to follow the customs efficiency. So What's easier for customs if it substantially makes the drawback claimant's life more difficult, then those are can be broadly construed. They're pretty broad statements. If you can qualify, then you can respond to customs with proposition to say to withdraw the request to restructure. All right, so let's take a look at how this is being tested. As you notice, once you have a laundry list of items, right? Once you have the laundry list of items, whether on the exception side or whether on the factor side, customs is likely to test you by asking you which one is not, and they give you all the ones that are, and you have to pick out the one that doesn't fit one of those line item criteria. So question goes like this: which one of the following criteria is used in demonstration of a claimant is not used in demonstration of claimant order to exempt from restructuring of drawback? So customs comes back with restructuring. The claimant must think of some exception criteria. So we look at the exception list and we just mix and match, right? So the first answer deals with complexities caused by multiple manufacturing. So we have multiple manufacturing commodities. Oh, we have locations. Okay, I'm sorry. So locations are here. So this fits the one of the correct criteria. So B, E, we're looking for the one that's not. B is the reason. So we move on. Complexities caused by significantly different methods of operation. Significantly different methods of operation is on the list. So B is good. C, complexities caused by misinterpretation of various regulations. So if you cannot read various regulations, that's really your problem, because regulations, even though they're complex, they may be complex, right? This may not be the reason, because regulations are there to regulate you. If it's too difficult for you, hire an expert, all right? It's not on operational side, it's on the interpretative side. This is something which you're expected to know, you're expected to read. As you're preparing for the exam, when you sit on the exam, you're expected to know all those complexities. If not, you will not pass. So this is not on the list. The regulations are not on the list, even though derivatively you may have some kind of in records which are subject to regulations, right? But it's not the interpretation, it's the adjustment, okay? It's the compliance adjustment cost. It's not the interpretative methodology cost. So C is not on the list. Since we're looking for the one that's not, this fits the bill. It's always a good idea, even though once you find this, to keep continue knocking others out, because under the best answer rule, you may find something weird down the line, which can raise a red flag. So D, complexities caused by difficulty in adjusting accounting inventory records. Well, that is right on point too. Difficulty in adjusting inventory and accounting records. So D is all right. E, complexities caused by multiple commodities or applicable general manufacturing drawback ruling or specific manufacturing drawback ruling. So the drawback ruling, general specific manufacturing, is on the list, so this one is okay. So since we're looking for one that's not, this is clearly the line item which is missing from those six reasons to say no. So C is our choice. All right.